Hansen out of bounds at the 10-yard line. So the strategy, obviously, playing keep it out of the hands of Brian Roberson.
Yeah, except for you don't want to kick it out of bounds. I think they wanted to limit how much field they had to cover by kicking it down to the corner, and that one drifted out of bounds.
There's a look at Jim Arianis, a transfer from LA Valley College. He was an All-American honorable mention a year ago. If you look at his numbers this season, he has traded some duties, some playing time with Richie Donati. The game we did last year, Donati was a starter for Fresno State, but it's been a season of this week Arianis, next week Donati. So Sweeney decides to go with his JC transfer from LA Valley College.
He's coming off a subpar performance, and Sweeney said even though he wasn't as good as he'd like to him to have been last week, he's still going to start him this week.
Jerome Oliver, the tailback on first down, picks up three past the 35 to the 30, let's call it the 38-yard line.
Let's take a look at the Gene Harvey starting offensive line for the Bulldogs. A lot of changes for that group. Osmondson, kind of the old anchor there in that offensive line that keeps that group together. The backs and receivers, Charlie Jones, one of the all-time leading receivers here at Fresno State, leads in yardage, touchdown catches he can break today. Just a great deep threat, but also he catches the ball over the middle.
Charlie Jones been around this program a long time, three-year letterman, and the handoff goes to Reggie Brown, the top rusher on this Bulldog team. Timmy McTyre, the left corner, makes the stop. As we look at the Gene Harvey defensive starters, Bloomfield, who came in midseason for Ulofali after his suspension, anchors that defensive line. Spencer Reed will get the start in this first half. Shea Muirbrook will not play in the first half. He is serving a half-game suspension after a breakout last week against Utah. And Jermell Reed, who's been battling some knee problems, will be at one corner. Pretty good secondary for Brigham Young. McTyre, Cook, Sampson. Third down and two. And the pass complete. That was Brian Roberson.
And Brian Roberson is fearless going across the middle. Anybody that'll stand under a punt and return a punt is not going to be afraid to go across the middle on a throw. This is what BYU secondary likes to have. They like to have receivers coming across the middle, but when they hit you like this, they expect the ball to come out onto the turf. Roberson concentrates. You see him watching that ball all the way in. Even when he was taking the contact, he had his eyes on that football, brought it in for a very big first down for Fresno here early in the game.
48th reception for Roberson, a 5'10", 170-pound junior. So the Bulldogs start with a first down on their first drive of the day, and not much off the right side. The fullback, Reggie Brown, tackled by Bloomfield out of Taylorsville, Utah. Reggie Brown, interesting story. Missed the last two games because of knee problems. They decide Monday to go ahead and scope his left knee. And here he is 6 days later playing on a scope knee, 5 days, 6 days ago.
It's amazing to me, Craig. You just go back 10 years ago and the scope knee would keep you out for several weeks. Now they do surgery on a player on Monday. Plays in the football game on Saturday. It's just amazing.
There's Jim Sweeney, 18th season at Fresno State, looking for his 140th victory here as the head coach of the Bulldogs. He's been in this coaching game a long time at Montana State, Washington State. He has 196 career wins. Ariana swings it out to Michael Pittman, who just checked in, the sophomore from San Diego. And Pittman bangs inside the 40, and they will mark him at the 37-yard line.
He's just going to try to take away BYU's pass rush by coming underneath with a little quick screen. You saw Pittman step up into the line, get lost, and come out into the left flat for a screen pass, and the blocking down front was very good with Conrad and Weathers out in front. Take a look from the end zone coming right at you. You see the tackle and the guard. Conrad and Weathers out in front. Make a nice seam for Pittman to get up on that screen pass to the left.
Third down and short. Hand off, Brown. First down for Reggie Brown. Hard to bring down the 230-pounder on short yardage. Matt Redden made the tackle. There's a look at Lavelle Edwards. 24th season, 213 victories, the fourth winningest active coach. Sweeney is number seven. And we said it so many times in the pregame show and at the top of this broadcast, the importance of this game. Brigham Young still in the Holiday Bowl hunt, though very slim. they are looking beyond the Holiday Bowl at other bowl opportunities with a victory today. Play action by Arianis lets it fly downtown and nearly picked off at the goal line, incomplete. Double coverage provided on Charlie Jones by Sampson. And now we got an injured Cougar down. That is Dermel Reed, who's had some knee problems this season.
But it looked like he came up, and he's had that bad knee. And he went up to intercept the ball and came down hard on the leg. And we hope that's not an aggravation of that knee problem. But we'd have to suspect with that weak knee that that might be what it is. Excellent coverage by Reed that time, running stride for stride with Charlie Jones, who is a very good deep threat for the Fresno State Bulldogs. Take a look at the positioning. Excellent coverage. They're going to play action pass, doesn't fool the secondary. Dermel Reed is running underneath, and then you have Sampson, the free safety, coming over to help. And let's take a look if you see if he comes down.
Ooh,
and you see that his own man, Sampson, came down on that left leg of Dermel Reed just at the very end. Take a look here as they come to the ground. You're going to see, watch the left leg planted, and then Sampson comes right down on that left leg.
And Dermel needing assistance off the field. You can see the left leg hanging. George Curtis, the trainer, will try to get a report from Doug Miller. James Dye checks in at the right corner for Dermel Reed.
You know what this does to BYU, Craig? When Dye has to play as a regular on defense, it takes away a little of his effectiveness returning punts.
Second down, 10. Charlie Jones, so shifty. Jamie Cook chased him out. That stops the clock with 11:15 to play, opening quarter.
When Lane Martin had Charlie Jones hemmed in the backfield, and look at the elusiveness of Charlie Jones. This is why he's so good after he catches a football. He just freezes Martin and then goes right around him. The play by Martin allowed enough time for Jamie Cook to come up from his safety position and force Jones out of bounds, but what a move Jones makes on Martin to get to the outside.
Third down conversions, 41% on the season for Fresno State. Bulldogs now looking at third down and 10 at the 35-yard line of Brigham Young. Opening drive, play action. Arianis going over the middle, got a man, but overthrows his wide receiver by a good 5 yards. Arnold, the intended receiver. And so that brings up fourth down for Jim Sweeney and his Bulldogs.
I think Arnold is probably glad that ball was overthrown because Tim McTyre was looming large right in front of Arnold as he came across the middle waiting to make the hit.
Jeff Roberts. Will punt it away for the 39th time, averaging under 39 yards a kick. This will be a little soft pooch kick by Roberts. Takes a bounce at the 6, and the Bulldogs down it. Nope, touchback.
Rio Wells made a great effort to get down and cover that kick, just not quite enough hang time on the football for him to get down and get his feet established, and the ball got into the end zone.
It takes a bounce at the 1, almost. Not able to get the feet down. Scoreless. We'll come back. Brigham Young, first offensive series of the afternoon. There's the trigger man, Steve Sarkisian, went over the 3,000-yard mark last week against Utah. 17 touchdowns, 4 interceptions. 14 interceptions. He wishes it was 4. 11:02 in the first quarter. First play from scrimmage for Brigham Young. Handoff, Hey Mooley. He'll pick up a couple to the 21. Let's take a look at the Gene Harvey offensive starters for Brigham Young. Elias Fa'apula at the right guard. Unatoa the center. Moran Johnson along with Matt Cox at the right tackle. Hey Mooley, the captain, one of the co-captains offensively at the fullback spot. And Sarkisian, the quarterback. A pickup of 2, second down 8. Brigham Young stays on the ground, and nothing there. Atuaya wrapped up in a hurry by Steve Kasner, the right end. big number 57.
Let's take a look at the Gene Harvey starting defense for the Bulldogs. Steve Kastner, the right end, physical player, upfield rusher. It's a good group of front people for the Bulldogs. Andre Griggs, the strong backer, along with Bigelow and Adams. And the secondary, Marlon Jackson. And Stoutmire, Craig, leads this team and the conference in tackles with 178. I don't know how you get involved in 178 tackles in the course of the season. That just astounds me as I read that stat.
Now, Stoutmire averaging 16 tackles a ball game. They flip it out. Atulamili, first down, hurdles up to the 34, 35-yard line. First down, Brigham Young, Woody Green, and Steve Wilson. Brought down Mealy, but Atula showing that great athletic ability to hurdle for the first down. Let's check in with Doug Miller. Doug.
Morning news for Dermell Reed. I don't know if you can see him sitting there on the bench dejectedly on the right side. They say it's a re-injury of the ligaments in that left knee. They're going to put a brace on it. Dermell is very emotionally pled. Put a brace on it, coach. I want to see how it feels. I can play. But I don't think it's likely Dermell will see action again this afternoon.
Always the toughest sight in football. Seeing a guy out there with the knee problem. Oh. Less than 10 minutes to play, opening quarter. And Brigham Young trying to get a ground game established. And Tony Sargent made the tackle, number 91 for Fresno State.
There was some talk this last week, Craig, from Hemahe Mooley himself, saying we got away from our running game too early last week. We need to establish that run to take the pressure off of our quarterback, Steve Sarkisian. And here early, BYU going very much with the running game, and I would not be surprised to see them stick with that even if it doesn't go well early.
A 2-yard pickup for Mark Atuaya. Second down, 8. Mike Johnston in motion, sets up in the slot. Play action, Sarkisian sets and guns. Johnston at midfield. Mark him at the 48-yard line of Fresno State.
BYU brings Johnston in motion across the formation. It makes an easy read for the quarterback. That's why a lot of teams do motion. As he came across, a defender ran with him. So Sarkisian knows right from the start, I've got man-to-man coverage. And as Johnston plants his foot and comes back across the field, he knows that he's going to be working one-on-one against Woody Green, and he's able to beat Green across the field for the first down.
Johnston now catching a pass in 20 consecutive games. Just a very good possession type of receiver. In the ball game, K.O. Kalalui in motion. On first and 10 from the Bulldog 47. Atuaya breaks it up to the 39. So a pickup of 8, and that will bring up a second down and short. Lumumba Neal. Been waiting all day to say his name.
I've been waiting all day for you to say it, too.
Lumumba Neal. Yeah, the left tackle, 6'3", 285 out of Oakland, made this tackle, and no question, Lumumba makes the all-name team.
That's for sure. He's on the team. Just a little draw trap for BYU inside that they've run so well over the years to Mark Atuaya. They pull that right guard across. Elias Fapula makes the block for Mark Atuaya on the run.
Second down short. 39-yard line of Fresno State. Scoreless here in the first quarter. Atuaya slips and falls as the speedster tried to make a cut at the 40-yard line. Woody Green brought him down at the 39.
Look at Mark Atuaya out of Laie, Hawaii.
Injured Bulldog on the far side of the field.
Let's take a look at the footing here. The grass is very closely cropped. It's almost like running on artificial turf, except for the players have cleats on, and you see as he went to plant that left foot, the footing came right out from under him. I think that as this field, it's Bermuda grass down there, as the year drags on and it gets drier and cooler, the turf is not quite as thick and lush as it would be early in the season.
Well, it's quite a lead block by Elias Fa'apula, number 57. Looks like the injured player is Sargent, number 91.
Yeah, Shatoni Sargent, the defensive end, left end. He and Leroy Colbert rotate in to spell one another. Junior out of Long Beach, California. And that is who it is.
6'5", 280. So Sargent able to leave the field under his own power. Third down conversions versus Utah. And this was a problem a week ago for Brigham Young. Only 3 of 11. Cougars looking at third and two. Long snap by Sarkisian, the give. And Steve Kasner makes the tackle. Got some help from the strong safety, Marlon Jackson.
And Tafua Bloomfield had come into the game for Mark Atuaya at the tailback spot. And just a great job by Kasner and the whole group to close down, including Adams, to close down that running lane for Tafua Bloomfield. They won the battle that time on the offensive and defensive lines, and BYU will be forced to punt.
Roberson, number two in the nation in punt returns at just over 18 yards, and a big strong kick by Alan Boardman takes a bounce at the one. And so Fresno State will start up on their second series of the day at their own 20-yard line. We'll step aside. 6:20 to play in the first quarter. We'll be back. Now there's Mike Ulafali, big number 98, who made an early exit last week against Utah. Voted back onto the team by his defensive peers, and Ulafali makes his first appearance on the second series for Fresno State. Play action, Arianis, and the pass complete. Jerome Oliver on second effort picks up the first down. Spencer Reed, the middle backer, who's playing in place of Shea Muirbrook, who has to sit out this first half because of a penalty last week against Utah, makes the tackle.
They just brought Jerome Oliver. He was the man that they faked to. He came right up the middle of the field and just turned in that zone in between the linebackers. Easy throw for Arianis. And Fresno goes with a two-headed tailback here. They'll rotate Jerome Oliver and Pittman in. Between the two tailbacks, they have over 1,000 yards rushing this year.
Oliver played junior college ball at Ricks. Arianis on the throw and a nice comebacker. The catch made by Charlie Jones. Those are the passes, Blaine. That's his 67th catch of the season. He is Fresno State's career leader in receptions. Over nearly 3,300 yards of pass receptions, and he's tied with Henry Ellard. We know what Ellard's done in touchdown receptions at 25.
Well, they've had outstanding receivers here at Fresno State, a great tradition of receivers, and Charlie Jones definitely upholds that tradition as you see him use the great footwork on the sideline to get the feet inbounds. That would have been a good catch in the NFL. He got both down working against James Dye on the outside.
There's Charlie Jones at 5'10", 170. So far, pretty impressed with the job. Arianis coming off three picks against Wyoming last week, and Jim Sweeney concerned. Lavelle Edwards obviously concerned about which quarterback Sweeney would use today. But Arianis so far has been right on. 5:55 to play, first quarter, scoreless, and contact made, and now flags are down.
But John Ross just launched himself across the line of scrimmage.
You can't get back at 300 pounds.
Now, once you get that much going.
Encroachment. With contact, 5 yards, still first down.
As the officials today, Dean Reimer, the ump. Some of these officials hopeful they'll find themselves in some postseason bowl games. From the eye and the explosion. Charlie Jones brought down by Ed Keel, the freshman left end. Check that, it's Pittman 34.
When Pittman started early, very effective early in the year for the Fresno Bulldogs. He got nicked up just a little bit, little nagging injuries that have slowed him down. And some of the coaching staff here feel that he has not been himself since the beginning of the year, that he really hasn't broken out to play the way they expected him to play after he got banged up early in the year.
still averaging 4.5 yards per carry. Reggie Brown, the fullback, Arianna saw the play action across the middle and the connection made and the catch by Charlie Jones. Tim McTyre, the left corner, brought him down at the 29-yard line. And now a flag down, and they're going to bring this one back.
It's going to come back with a holding penalty, but Craig, I, like you, am very impressed with the way Arianna is throwing that football early in the game. Charlie Jones on a crossing route covered by Jamie Cook, and the coverage was pretty much there. It was tight. The ball had to be thrown just on the other side of the linebackers in between the safeties, and that throw is just perfect for Arianas. He's definitely on a roll here early in the game with his throwing.
So the penalty marks it to the 32-yard line. And that brings up first down and 28. Jim Sweeney, a couple of WAC titles in 92, 93. First and 28, Arianas rolls out, buys some time, guns and fires, and he puts it on a string. Arnold from Sunnyvale, California, on the receiving end of that bullet from Arianas. Can't understand why he was an All-American honorable mention last year at LA Valley College. Sarkisian was the first team All-American selection from
out of El Camino Junior College.
Yeah.
And Arnold showing me not only does he have a good arm, but he has very good footwork as he drops back. He looks like he's very quick with his feet. Arnold, of course, one of his favorite targets to go to, second on this team receiving, came into the game with 48 receptions.
Back to the ground, Reggie Brown. And we talked about this earlier, Blaine, the ability to set up the run, which will then open up the pass. And so far, Fresno State getting the job done. Eddie Sampson made the stop.
Take a look at this from behind the offense. They come with a draw trap. And I can tell you right now that Jim Sweeney is very excited to have Brown back in the lineup. They're spreading the football around. They've run all three of their backs. Arianas has 5 completions to 5 different receivers. And they're really have BYU's defense guessing right now.
First and 10 from the 37. Good protection, but the pocket collapses and down goes Arianas at the 40. Matt Redden, the first to put the pads on him. Got some help from Bloomfield.
And BYU got good upfield pressure that time. Came around the outside and forced him to step up into the pocket. And Redden was relentless in his pursuit, ran all the way around the quarterback Arianas, and then took his legs out from under him from the backside.
25th sack for BYU's defense.
Henry Bloomfield also in on the play.
Fresno State's offensive line, Blaine, doing a pretty good job. That was only their 17th sack they've given up this season. That's less than 2 a game. Arianas on the quick throw to the near sideline. Nice move. Charlie Jones dances out of bounds at the 31. Brad Martin, outside backer, pushed him out.
And Lane Hale came up quickly on Charlie Jones to try to make the hit at the line of scrimmage. Just a quick hitch route. And this is what makes Charlie Jones so good. He's very elusive. You can't get a good solid hit on him. And Lane Hale thinks he's got a beat on Charlie Jones, just steps inside the tackle as Hale over pursues and then gets safely out of bounds.
Stops the clock with 3:04 to go. Opening quarter. We're scoreless if you just joined us here at Bulldog Stadium, Fresno, California. Third down, 5. Arianas again to the air and the completion. Roberson on the far side, still on his feet and knocked down at the 18-yard line. Lane Hale made the tackle, and right now this Bulldog crowd very much in this football game.
When Brian Roberson had a lot of cushion that time on top from Tim McTyre. On a third down situation, take a look. He just goes out and sits underneath. McTyre's 8 yards off the receiver as the pass is delivered from Arianas out to Roberson. can't give that much cushion on a third and short. Arianas now 7 of 9 for 85 yards in this football game, and he's throwing the ball with great confidence.
Back to the ground, Pittman to the 15, maybe the 14, Ed Keel, the left end, red shirt out of Sandy, Utah. Wrapped him up. Hey, Brad Martin, he's coming home, Clovis, California, just nearby, 6'1", 230-pound freshman. You know, Dennis Simmons went down early this season with a shoulder problem. Martin steps in, won't give up that spot.
No, and a freshman out there playing on a regular basis, he's going to have a lot of good years to come for the BYU Cougars.
Flags come down, still 5 seconds left on the play clock.
I think that someone on the interior front for Fresno State moved before the snap of the ball.
Dead ball foul. False start on the offense, 5 yards, still second down.
Now last time Fresno State had the football, they had problems with the offensive hold.
And yeah, penalties plagued them. You see the entire left-hand side obviously didn't get the signal straight in the huddle, as both Chris Conrad and Alan Weathers jumped offside.
Second flag on Fresno State for 23 yards on the day. Under 2 minutes to go in the first quarter, scoreless. Bulldogs knocking on the door. Arianas over the middle, dumps it. Up goes the touchdown to Roberson. And Blaine, that was one-on-one with the two fastest men in the country, Roberson and James Dye. This time, Roberson picks up his fourth touchdown.
Roberson went down and ran a post corner out. He went down and went hard to the post, and as James Dye tried to jump on the post, he planted his foot, went back out to the corner, and Dye was too far away to be able to recover. Take a look, he's going to go down and force Dye to think he's going to the inside on the post, and then plants that foot to go back out to the corner. And Dye not able to react to the football quick enough.
Bad snap, and the kick fades to the left. So Johan Lassan unable to connect on the point after. And it's Fresno State 6, Brigham Young nothing. We'll come back to Bulldog Stadium after this. Here's Brian Roberson. Pulled down his fourth touchdown of the season. 10 plays, the Bulldogs went 80 yards, 4:35 off the clock, and Roberson caps it off with a 20-yard catch from Arianas. Lassan with the kick. Cooper at the 7. Cooper at the 20, 25. Cuts it near side, 35, 40. And chopped down at the 49-yard line. Cooper fighting for the return from Dye, and Cooper takes it to the 49-yard line. Brought down by Corey Hall.
And you see Lavelle Edwards kind of take Cooper aside and say, "Hey, let's take it easy here. We don't want to get any penalties for celebration." But you're right, Craig. Cooper actually took that football away from James Dye, and I think as a coaching staff, they typically don't want that to happen. They'd like to have James Dye returning those.
Lassan actually came up to make the tackle, the kicker. 6-0, Fresno State. Mike Johnston, the motion man from the shotgun. And Hamuli stood up, dropped for a 1 yard loss, and the little counter draw did not fool Fresno State's front. And up comes from the free safety spot, Omar Stoutmeyer, and that is why he averages 16 tackles a game.
You don't expect your free safety to be making tackles 3 yards deep in the backfield, and that time Stoutmeyer, see how quickly he comes up? He makes run read, and he's not worried about pass at all. He steps right up and makes the hit.
No gain on the play, second down 10 from the Cougar 49. Sarkisian, quick step, and a quick drop and a quick throw. The tight end, Atulamili, He'll pick up 6 yards to the 45, brought down by the middle linebacker, Ryan Holmes. Atula Mealy, he's averaging 5 catches a game.
And it's hard to say when somebody's averaging 5 catches a game that they're not using him enough, but I truly believe that they have got to get the football in his hands more. He's such a great athlete, and as he's running against linebackers like Ryan Holmes throughout the day, they have got to get him the football and let him do what he does best, and that's run the ball.
First quarter game clock winding down with 14. Sarkisian throws the out. Johnston dances, breaks a tackle, 35-yard line, and pushed back, but they will give his forward progress to the 35. That stops the clock with 8 seconds left.
Steve Wilson, number 7, and Woody Lee, number 22.
Actually, Kaipo McGuire on the reception did have the first down yardage. Looks like he had a little bit of calling from somebody to the sideline to come in for him. He gets his helmet checked out there.
And we're going to wind down the first quarter clock as Sarkisian will unsnap the helmet, talk things over with Norm Chow, Lavelle Edwards. We've played one quarter in Fresno. The Bulldogs on top, 6-0. We'll come back after this. ...15 minutes to play in the half. Fresno State leading 6-0. Touchdown pass to Roberson, but the extra point was off the mark.
On the bench there.
Sarkisian will roll, looking for help downfield. Guns and fires, and the catch is made and complete at the 18-yard line. K.O. Kealalui, brought down by Chris Love, the weak side linebacker.
Boy, and the key to this play, Craig, Sarkisian has all kinds of time. He rolls out to the left. And then you see Kealalui, he's able to motion him back to the middle of the field. He was covered on the break, running a curl route. He motioned him back to the middle and was able to throw the football. You can't allow him that much time, or his receivers will be open every time.
Sarkisian, 4 of 4 for 44 yards. Arianas, 8 of 10 for 105 yards in that first quarter. Sarkisian looking for 6, throws the corner out, touchdown. Mike Johnston hauls down the pass from Sarkisian, but there is a flag.
Now that one came late after the touchdown. We may see another celebration penalty here. Well, Sarkisian caught Fresno in a man-to-man blitz situation with no safety in the middle of the field. He audibled to the play. Let's listen to what the penalty is.
After the touchdown, unsportsmanlike conduct against the offense.
Yeah, we're going to get that dreaded celebration penalty, which I think is the most ridiculous penalty in football. But, yeah, he caught him. He audibled to a man-to-man route and caught him on a corner route in the end zone. He brought Johnston inside and then ran him on a corner route. Fresno showed the defense early and then stayed in it. You've got to mix your defenses up. You've got to show one thing and at the snap of the ball jump into another, or Sarkisian will pick you apart. Let's take a look at the celebration afterward. Oh, he spun the football on the ground.
Yeah, that's...
You can't do that, Craig.
I don't care if it's Notre Dame. I don't care if it's a slippery rock. I mean, I don't care. I mean, that's... Come on. You play the game. It's an emotional game. And the kick by Hansen is true. Hansen now 28 of 30 on the point after attempts. As you look at Johnston hauling down his 6th touchdown reception of the season. Brigham Young by 1. We'll be back.
Welcome back to the home of the Dogs. You can hear them come alive here as the Cougars take the lead 7-6. Not incidentally either, it was the BYU bench, Norm Chow and Lavelle Edwards, frustrated that their inability to get that running game going. They said Sarkisian's going to open it up. He did with consecutive passes that connected in the end zone, and BYU takes the lead 7-6. Mort.
All right, thanks, Doug. Well, you can't really tell the emotion of Lavelle Edwards. We see it week after week. But the scoring drive looks like this. 5 plays. 50 yards, less than 2 minutes off the clock, and Johnston, 19-yard catch from Sarkisian, his 18th touchdown toss of the season. And the penalty, by the way, marked off at the kickoff, so instead of the 35, Hansen will have to kick from the 20. Roberson and Arnold. back to receive. Arnold at the 15. Arnold with the throw. Over the shoulder catch. Roberson, and great second special teams coverage by Brigham Young. Boy, there was absolutely no doubt by that special teams on what they were going to do down the field. Ben Cook did some sniffing and was able to make the tackle.
Boy, you tell your cover team, you've got to stay in your lanes. Stay in your lanes no matter what. And look at BYU's Ben Cook. He stayed right out in his lane. As the ball was thrown over to Roberson, he is out there, Roberson, to make the tackle. And that's just good, disciplined cover play by BYU's cover team.
How about the catch? I mean, Roberson had to catch this over his shoulder.
Yeah, it's a good thing he's a receiver, because he had to make an adjustment and turn back downfield to make that catch.
From the 24-yard line, Jerome Oliver running through tackles to the 33, and that stops the clock with 14:13 to play in the half. Eddie Sampson made the stop, but Jerome Oliver, he's a big back. He's a short kid at 5'9", 200 pounds. Played his junior college ball at Ricks out of Wichita, Kansas.
You know, Jerome Oliver is the size that you see a lot more running backs in the NFL right now. 5'9", 200, 5'9", 210, a la Barry Sanders size.
Emmett
Smith size. They seem to be more durable.
Thurman
and
Thomas.
They're harder to tackle. That's right. The shorter, stockier, quick guys are doing well in football right now at the running back position.
Reggie Brown, the ball carrier. I'll tell you, Arianas, nice job. Faked the pitch, handed it off, and then went on with the pitch. It was an interesting play by Arianas. The Brown stopped for no gain.
Boy, and BYU decided to open up their offense, and here Fresno State comes out with a trick play on the kickoff, but they've gone with run plays here to get them a first down.
From the 36-yard line, Ariana steps and fires, strong arm, and the connection made. Charlie Jones at the 47-yard line. And on coverage, they're picking on James Dye right now, who's had to come in relief of the injured Dermell Reed.
Well, that's the thing you do when you have a backup come in, you test him out early, and that's what Fresno State has done. And Charlie Jones is always such a threat to go deep on you that you've got to give him that cushion. And as James Dye gives that cushion, he can break down and come on that comeback and be open all day long.
There's Charlie Jones, averages over 102 yards a game receiving. And right up the middle goes Michael Pittman. Eddie Sampson brought it down, but not before a 12-yard pickup by Pittman at the 40 of Brigham Young.
Well, Pittman comes in, as you mentioned, Craig, with a 4.5-yard average, and he exploded through the hole that time, right up the middle of BYU's defense.
Clock running, coming up on the 13-minute mark of the first half. 7-6, Brigham Young. From the eye, the pitch to Pittman. Turns the corner, and that stops the clock. At the 37, Eddie Sampson. And a Tacoma, Washington. He's the number two leading tackler on this Cougar defense. The top hitter is Jamie Cook, so you got the strong safety and the weak safety teaming up to go 1 and 2.
Boy, when Fresno State runs that ball up the middle, you know that BYU misses Shane Yerbrook in the middle, and they'll have him back in the second half.
Let's check in with Doug Miller. Doug?
Look at James Dye, number six. On his right hand, his fourth finger, the ring finger and middle finger taped together. That fourth finger was badly smashed between a couple of helmets earlier, smashed and bleeding badly. They've kind of patched it up, but Dye's got to be feeling some of that pain.
Arianas picking again on Dye along the far side. Roberson makes the reception down to the 20-yard line. Took four white jerseys to bring him down, led by Spencer Reed, number 41. Boy, very impressed with the way Roberson able to run his routes. Got a flag down at the 15-yard line.
And that one again came at the end of the play. Some unsportsmanlike conduct against Fresno this time.
Boy, Jim Sweeney is hot. There he is. I just looked up and he was out on the field.
Well, he's saying it got pulled off, and I wonder, I'm trying to read Coach Jim Sweeney's lips. He's saying, hey, it got pulled off. It got pulled off. And if the penalty, you're not allowed to take your helmet off to draw attention to yourself with a celebration rule, and maybe that's what the call was.
Unsportsmanlike conduct against the offense. Offense had made the line to gain. It will be first down and 10.
Let's take a look, and I don't know if we'll be able to see much from this. Sweeney's claiming that the helmet got pulled off. He wasn't celebrating, the helmet got pulled off. And let's take a look and see if we see anything from Roberson here. By the way, James Dye, who was in on the tackle right there, number six, came limping off after the play.
Boy, hard to tell on that pileup. Penalty moves the ball back to the 35-yard line, but a first down for Fresno State. Arianas, a junior college transfer, doing a fine job leading this Bulldog offense in the first half, and Fresno stays on the ground. Matt Redden, who missed a series because of a hyperextended elbow, back in to make the tackle on Michael Pittman.
I wouldn't be surprised, and Sweeney's still arguing the point that that was, in his opinion, a bad call. I've already stated my opinion on this. I don't like the call to begin with, the celebration rule, but Sweeney very upset, saying that the helmet was pulled off and he didn't take the helmet off to draw any attention to himself.
Second down, 5. And now whistles will stop play. Flag down at the 30.
James Dye out. And we saw him limp off. Dustin Staley, number 13, and is in now.
On the offense, 5 yards, still second half.
And I wouldn't be surprised if Fresno State, they've been going at James Dye, who was in there for an injured Dermell Reed. And now, let's see if they go right at, boy, Sweeney is, he doesn't get too excited about it.
That's two plays ago, and he still hasn't thought, hadn't put it aside.
Jim Sweeney, he's not an excitable guy at all.
4 flags against Fresno State for 43 yards, a couple for Brigham Young for 20. It's interesting, there's kind of a pattern developing here for Fresno State. They get down around the 30-yard line and the penalties start to keep pushing them back. They've moved the ball well between the two 30-yard lines. They swing it out to set up the screen. Reggie Brown stumbles and falls at the 37-yard line.
Boy, he had a little bit of a seam. Lane Martin did come through unblocked from his linebacker position, but the screen was sold very well at the beginning. Arianas does a nice acting job of looking upfield, drawing the defensive line to him. Now watch Lane Martin. He's got 3 guys out there blocking, and everyone just says, well, I guess you'll get Martin. I guess he'll get Martin. And he runs through untouched. Brown trying to make the cut, goes down to the turf.
Numbers of before this game on Reggie, 694 yards rushing. Third down, 11. Arianas rolls and fires. Got a man wide open at the 7-yard line. Jaheen Arnold, the senior from Sunnyvale. And the Bulldogs pick up a first down. It will be first and goal at the 7.
When Eddie Sampson and Jamie Cook both in coverage that time, trying to catch up with Jaheen Arnold. He went down again. Same route they scored on earlier with Roberson. Fake the post and go to the corner. And Jamie Cook not able to recover. You see the end of it as Cook tries to run and Sampson tries to come and hang out. Help out. Almost got a hand on that football. The coverage was there, but good concentration by Arnold to bring that one in.
First and goal, 7-yard line of Brigham Young. Arianas, the handoff to Pittman, stacked up and dropped at the 6. Eddie Sampson flew in from his weak side safety spot to make the tackle. Sampson out of Tacoma, Washington.
Boy, this is where you want to be able to run the football, Craig, get down inside the 10-yard line. If you can get a good gain on first down, then play action.
Hey, how about those numbers? 12 of 14, 170 yards and the 1 touchdown to Roberson in the first quarter. Still 10-10 to play in the first half. on the bootleg. Arianas fires, knocked down. Good defensive effort by Brigham Young's secondary. That was Jamie Cook, who barely was unable to tip that last ball away. This time comes back with a nice defensive effort.
You know, I just mentioned, if you get a good gain on first down, that sets up the play action. Well, Fresno was stopped on first down, so the play action fooled no one. BYU was right in their drops, had the zones covered well in the end zone, and Jamie Cook just stepped right in front of Warren Fortier, was able to knock the ball away.
Third down, goal from the 6-yard line. Arianas, the quick throw and the catch made. Arnold down to the one. Sampson brought him down, so this will be an interesting decision by Sweeney. You know what the crowd wants? They want to say, push it on in, Jim. And Michael Pittman's going to check in, along with Jamie Kimbrough, their big fullback.
And that time, Fresno just cleared out the coverage. And they brought Arnold underneath. They're going to go for it here.
There are flags down. Reggie Brown dove in off the left side, but hold on, a flag. I think somebody off that right side of Brigham Young's defensive front jump.
That's what it looked like to me. And so I think it will stand. That is the initial call. Offside on BYU, it will be declined, and Fresno will get the 6 points. Take a look. Full house backfield, straight T. You saw the jump on the defensive line by Ross. They give it to Reggie Brown, who goes up and over the top for 6 points.
And now Sweeney. Ooh, I tell you, that right side also moving. Looked like John Ross. And the 8th touchdown run. Checked out the 9th for Reggie. And now Sweeney will go for 2. Pittman and Brown in the backfield. Arianas, the quick throw, the timing pattern to the corner. Got it, 2 points, Charlie Jones. Boy, Charlie Jones covered a lot of territory out there, coming out the slot. And Arianas hits him on stride. The Bulldogs have come back to take a 7-point lead. We'll be back. Well, the sun beginning to set here on Bulldog Stadium. Jim Sweeney, hey, this is their bowl game, Blaine, so they go for 2. And Charlie Jones, hey, what a great throw, though. I mean, you've got to tip your hat to Arianas to get that ball up and out. Charlie Jones runs underneath it to put him on top 14-7.
Yeah, that throw was, could not have been any more perfect, right on the sideline. He let Charlie Jones do what he does best, run to the football, adjust to the football, and get the 2-point conversion for you.
Bulldogs 13 plays, they move 76 yards, 5:04 off the clock, and the 1-yard touchdown by Brown. The kick is away at the 10-yard line. Tafua, Bloomfield stacked up at the 26. A 17-yard return for Tafua, sophomore in a West Valley City, Utah. Let's check in with Doug Miller. Doug?
Bowler, a lot of pregame questions about whether or not the defensive unit had their head in this game after all the distractions, some of the turmoil, the little rift that developed after last week's game. Still some questions about that here on the bench. You hear some rumblings about it. Sort of seem out of sync. One of the things, certainly they missed Muirbrook. He'll be back second half. That could be a factor. We'll wait to see.
All right, thanks, Doug. 9:19 to play in the half, 14-7, Fresno State. Sarkisian on the play action. Goes deep, got a man. Incomplete, and great defensive coverage by the right corner, Steve Wilson. Typo McGuire had him on the post. But Wilson able to come over and deflect the ball down.
Take a look. Sarkisian going to go to play action and try to get it all on the first down to come back and try to bite Fresno State back and get some momentum. And as McGuire was running the post, the ball a little bit underthrown. That had to be thrown out in front. You want your receiver to have to accelerate to the football. And the ball hung just a little bit and allowed the defense to come in and make the play.
You know, when Wilson leads the WAC in pass breakups, 19 pass breakups now. Cougars on the ground, out to Waya. To the 40, but a flag in the Cougar backfield at the 23.
Boy, Fresno was coming after BYU with a blitz that time. And when you've got a blitz on and you run a trap like that, if you get through the initial line of scrimmage, there's a lot of running room.
Stoutmeyer made the tackle on Atuaya, but this one's going to come back, holding the ball.
And no wonder there was such a big hole on that one. There was a big hole for Mark Atuaya to go through. And evidently someone held at the point of attack there.
Holding. 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Repeat second down.
So they'll mark off 10 yards. And that brings up second down at 23. Today's game is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, the low fare airline. Under 9 minutes to play in the half. Second down, 23 for Brigham Young. Johnston in motion. Sarkisian rolls and fires to Tulamili. And knocked down at the 18-yard line by Woody Green, number 22. Woody, little mismatch there, 5'11", 195. Atula weighs in around 240. And Green said, come at me.
Boy, in this Fresno State defense and the entire Fresno State team, you really see them start to be upbeat, to start to have some momentum and to believe that they can play with this BYU football team. Again, let's take a look at it as Mealy comes on the out. You mentioned it, working against Woody Green. Usually Mealy's going to win that contest.
Third down, 17. Keanu Louie in motion. Now Sarkisian rolls far side, throws it back to the near side. Mealy, a lot of running room. Atula turns it on and dances down the sideline, but the official marks him out at the 30. Chris Love able to squeeze that sideline out. And so Brigham Young picks up five, but still well short of the first down.
Boy, Mealy just ran out of sideline. He's going to be short of the first down on this play. Good call on third and 17. Try to make something happen. Get it in the hands of the guy that can make it happen. And I'll tell you what, if he doesn't go out of bounds, Mealy's still running right now. Brian Roberson will be back. They're a very dangerous kick returner to return this kick.
Charlie Jones lines up to the near side. They're going to bring him on the heavy rush. Boardman, ooh, bad kick off the side of his foot, trying to keep it away from Roberson, and it bounces out at the 29-yard line.
Well, and Craig, having to keep it away from a great return man is a real mental game for a punter. And you say, oh, don't kick it to him. Usually they just stand back there and boom it as hard as they can. And now you're telling them to keep it away. It's tough for those kickers.
Make sure you check your local listings for the start time in your area. Bulldogs want to run, and they give the football to Jerome Oliver. 8 yards for Oliver, finally pulled down by Eddie Sampson.
You see Eddie Sampson come out shaking his head. On a straight up the middle running play, he shouldn't have to make the tackle. Defensive lineman and your middle linebacker need to be there. And if Sampson's making all the tackles on runs, you've got some problems on defense.
Now Jamie Cook and Sampson came in with combined 179 tackles on the season. From the eye, Pittman. He bounced and, well, went about 2 yards back.
And Craig, I see Dermel Reed back out at corner. You know, Doug had mentioned that he had asked to put a brace on it and see if he could go with it, and I see him back out there at that quarterback position. And Fresno has been taking advantage of his absence, going at Dustin Staley and James Dye on that corner. There he is, number 7, Dermel Reed.
Well, we can pan on it. Obviously, see if we can tell if he's got a brace on or not. I don't see one. Looks like it's been wrapped, however. Keep your eye on Dermel. The pitch play. Here comes Oliver. And not much, but a first down at the 40, maybe the 41. And Reed came up from those right corner spot to put the hit on him along with Brad Martin. So Fresno State needed two. They got two and maybe 2 inches.
Keep the drive alive. Boy, really put his head down and drove for that first down.
Boy, I tell you, the secondary of Brigham Young, really a highlight this year, anchored by Reed, Sampson, Cook, and McTyre. They will hit you. Clock running, 6:43 to play in the half, 14-7 Fresno State. Looks like a busted play, and Arianas just takes a knee at the 35.
Yeah, that one was so messed up, I couldn't even tell you what it was supposed to be, because Arianas came back and looked very confused and said, just give me a place to hide so I don't get smacked, and got down on the turf.
I think Reggie Brown was the intended back on that play. Now, you miss a couple of weeks, you know? You kind of forget a play or two.
Get a little bit rusty with the offense. You would think, though, when you're getting the ball, you would remember.
That's right. You should know. Second down, 15. Arianas feels the pressure. Sidesteps trouble. Redden has a shot at him. Still gets the ball away, and it is picked off. Dermell Reed at the 40-yard line.
And the officials have not signaled that interception yet, but it sure looked like an interception for Dermell Reed. And Arianas making his first real mistake in the football game. It is going to go to BYU.
Hey, Dermell coming off a knee injury, comes back on the field. Second interception of the season, and it shuts down Fresno State at the 40-yard line.
When he went down to get that one, well, Arianas would like to have that back. When you've got people hanging all over you, you cannot throw it into a crowd unless you have somebody wide open that you can dig the ball to. And this time, he threw it into coverage, just trying to avoid a sack. He would have been better just to take that sack, obviously.
That was a hit on Arianas last week with the 3 interceptions against Wyoming. And now Brigham Young with good field position, under 6 minutes to play in the opening half, 14-7 Fresno State. Sarkisian got a man. Hey, Mooley stumbles and falls at the 24-yard line. He had some running room and he kept his feet.
Well, hey, Mooley last week against Utah was open on the same route. The ball was thrown out of bounds. This time he's going to come out of the backfield, machine number 15, on an out route, and then turn to the up. And Fresno State's expecting a linebacker to run with him. Ball just a little underthrown. He has to come back and get it. Had he been able to maintain his feet, and he looked like he grabbed and maybe hurt his stomach or a rib or something. If he had been able to maintain his feet, he'd still be running.
Numbers on Sarkisian, 9 of 10, 113 yards into one touchdown. And Mooley stays in at the slot, and the handoff to Fua Bloomfield to the 19-yard line. Ryan Holmes, the middle linebacker, put the hit on him. Tafua, only a sophomore, he was all everything at West Valley City. There's his numbers in 95, 238 yards before today's game. Pretty good average there, 5.3 a pop.
He's gradually learning this offense, and you'll see him play more and more as he gets a good grasp on all the blocking assignments and pass protection schemes that BYU has.
Second down, 6 from the Bulldog 20. 3 seconds on the play clock, going for the corner route, and overthrows McGuire. Coverage, Steve Wilson, the right corner.
On BYU's first touchdown, Craig, Sarkisian saw man-to-man tight coverage, checked into a corner route, and hit the touchdown. This time he saw it again, checked to a quick man-to-man fade for McGuire, but the coverage was there.
Brigham Young pitching 500 ball today on those third down conversions. Third down and 6 from the Bulldog 20. Bloomfield and Haymooley in the backfield. And now a timeout. Timeout on the field. We'll step aside with 4:43 to play in the half. Fresno State 14, Brigham Young 7. Craig Boulder, Jack, Blaine Fowler, Doug Miller back in Fresno, California. You look at the red zone this season. Brigham Young, 25 penetrations, well, 45 times. They've made 25 touchdowns, 9 field goals. They're looking at third down and 6 from the 20. Sarkisian steps and fires, and the catch made. And Keanu Louie down to the 12-yard line. And a first down for Brigham Young. Ryan Holmes, the middle backer out of Orange, California, made the tackle.
You see the official there talking to Keanu Louie. A lot of kicking and jockeying for position on the bottom of that pile.
I think it was Lamumba Neal, the left tackle, got tangled up with KO.
They just brought Keanu Louie from the outside on the right side of your screen across the middle. Ask him to catch that ball in traffic with the big boys. Ryan Holmes he runs into. Marlon Jackson also there. Lamumba Neal. I love that name.
Yeah, Lamumba. First and 10 from the Fresno State 11. Bloomfield gets the call at the 5, down to the 4-yard line. So Tafua picks up 6 on first down, tackled and knocked down by Steve Wilson. Let's check in with Doug Miller. Doug.
In that timeout just moments ago in the huddle you saw on the near sideline, BYU's huddle, Norm Chow said you've got to stick it in, you've got to put it in that end zone right now. You will not play it like you will not have another opportunity. And the Cougars are playing with that kind of intensity right now.
Second down 4 from the 5-yard line. And Mooley in motion. Trying to get a lead block for Bloomfield. He's stacked up and dropped at the 10. Loses the football back to Sarkisian.
I think, Craig, he may have lateraled that back. Sarkisian was looking like he was calling for the football, and Bloomfield threw it back. Excellent penetration by the whole left side of that Fresno State defense. Colbert and the gang. Tony Sargent also forced it back, and then Bloomfield does the thing you don't want him to. You can't reverse your field and lose yardage. And then it looked like he threw that ball back to Sarkisian. Take a look. He's going down. Sarkisian saying, give me the ball, give me the ball. And he actually does lateral that football back to Sarkisian.
Third down 9 from the 10. Sarkisian, the blitz is on. Sarkisian down at the 24. Chris Love led the charge, along with Andre Griggs.
Well, Craig, that is a situation where you cannot take a sack. That takes you back and makes it much more difficult for your field goal kicker. This is a ball where if you get outside and there's nothing left, you have to use every bit of arm strength you have to throw that football out of the end zone and give your field goal kicker a better opportunity. As it is, it's now going to be a 41-yard field goal attempt after the sack.
Bill Hansen, 9 of 15 in the field goal department. You see Chow having a talk with Sarkisian. Longest field goal for Hansen, a 50-yarder on the season. This will be from 41. The kick is up. And through the upright. So a 41-yard kick. And that cuts Fresno State's lead to 4, 14-10.
And we've seen an interesting phenomenon with Hansen this year, Craig. He's better from 40 out than he is from 29 in. Seems to struggle with the ones up close, and he nails those long-distance kicks. Hit the 50-yarder last week, and now a 41-yarder that was over the... I mean, look how much he has on this one. He has plenty of leg to get this one through from another 10 yards, and it's right down the middle.
I watched him in the warm-ups. He actually was hitting 52-yarders on a consistent basis in warm-ups today. And this kick is up and good height and good extension and through the middle.
When the Fresno State loyal fans here gave their defense a big hand for keeping BYU out of the end zone and forcing the field goal on that drive.
If you just joined us, Roberson started the scoring in the first quarter to make it 6-0. The PAT failed, and then Brigham Young comes back with a touchdown from Sarkisian to Johnston. Brown rumbles in. And then the Bulldogs convert on the two-point conversion to go up 14-7. And now Hansen has cut the lead to 14-10. Hansen's kick is away. Arnold at the goal line. Arnold at the 20. Arnold at the 25 to the 26.
Boy, for just a second there, it looked like Arnold had that sliver of room he needed to go all the way. But Jeff Ellis was able to come in and make the stick. You see 49 Ellis right there on the left side of your screen. He slides over and makes that hit. The only person left after that is Hansen, the kicker. And take a look at the blocking by the Fresno State return team. We had two guys out in front that would have escorted him into the end zone had he been able to get by Ellis.
1:41 to play in the half. 14-10 Fresno State. And the Bulldogs will run the handoff. Oliver and Spencer Reed, the middle backer, making the hit on Jerome Oliver, 200-pound senior out of Wichita.
Tell you, with a talented group of receivers and the good speed they have on the offense, if I were Fresno State, I'd try to get some more points on the board here and put the ball up in the air to get at least into field goal range with 1:11 to go.
From the eye, Jim Sweeney's going to keep it on the ground. A couple of yards, and this crowd boos Ross and Redden.
Yeah, I concur there. You've got the kind of skill people that Fresno State has. Get even more momentum as you go into the halftime with at least an attempt at a field goal, but it looks like Sweeney's content to let the clock run out and go in with a 14-10 halftime lead.
Redden slow to get up. And a Sweet Home, Oregon. Arianas with the quick throw and the catch. Pittman. Stan Ross. That stops the clock. Yeah, they will reset those chains on the sideline. First down for Fresno State.
Well, they went ahead and got the first down, yet I don't see Fresno clamoring to get to the line of scrimmage and get another playoff as the chains are reset and the clock now starts to run. Fresno State doesn't have to run another play.
Jaheen Arnold checks in. Number 8, he'll line up to the near side, bottom of your screen. 10 seconds. Arianas on the bootleg play action, sets up and fires, and a catch, and out of bounds goes Arnold at the 47. Yeah, you have to wonder,
trying to figure out what they're doing here, because
you got to throw the outs when you have a minute 20 to go, you know, to stop the clock.
If you wanted to get down into field goal range, you needed to start it earlier. Now you got 4 seconds. You can throw one ball into the end zone. And again, Arianas is right on the mark with his throws today. But do you have to wonder what they're thinking over there? It's just kind of a disjointed. It really isn't a very good two-minute offense that Fresno State has put together here at the end of the half.
Final 4 seconds. Arianas feeling pressure, rolls out of trouble, sets up off his back foot and fires, and incomplete, and that's going to do it. Well, a strange ending on that final series of the half for Fresno State. Brigham Young trailing 14-10. Sarkisian with one touchdown in that first half to Johnston. They're down 4. We'll be back. James Dye back to receive. The kick, 14-10 Bulldogs, and third quarter underway. Dye at the 15, Dye at the 25, and Dye spins to the 29-yard line.
Kind of a short kick on the play, Craig, and that might have been a good thing for Fresno State because it was short but very, very high. A lot of hang time on the football, and that allowed the cover team to get down there and hem James Dye in.
10 of 12, Sarkisian in the first half for 122 yards and the one touchdown. You know, interesting point. Dye getting the return yard. No return yards last week against University of Utah.
Yeah, it was great special teams play by Utah to keep the football out of his hands. Don't let him hurt you.
James Dyer, the number one punt return man in the nation, averaging 22.8 yards a kick.
And he hasn't had the opportunity to return a punt in this football game.
14:54.
Reset the clock. They had it at 14:37. Now it's reset at 14:54. Jim Sweeney with a four-point lead. Cougars start this third quarter with the football at the 30-yard line. 3 yards of rushing in the first half for BYU. Sarkisian will throw on first down. Out of the backfield comes Atuaya, and able to dance up to the 37-yard line. Call it the 36. Kevin Adams made the tackle.
BYU just trying to spread the linebackers out. They bring Atuaya out into the flat, Mealy underneath in coverage, and make them make a decision. Are you going to cover Atuaya, or are you going to cover Mealy? They chose to cover Mealy, and Atuaya is able to pick up good yardage on first down.
How about those quick feet? Atuaya dancing left, dancing right. You look at his numbers. 5 carries for 17 yards. Second down, 4. Atuaya hopping and skipping for a first down at the 42-yard line. Andre Griggs and Stoutmeyer team up to make the stop. So Brigham Young, Blaine, they're going to come out and establish the ground game. And in turn, old quarterback, that makes the pass, at least in philosophy, easier.
Well, it should make it easier, because you should be able to come with play action passes. You sure would like to have a second and short situation to be able to throw a play action pass in, and BYU hasn't had a lot of those in this game.
First and 10 from the 42-yard line. On the bootleg, Sarkisian dances from trouble. Down he goes, 37-yard line. Had a moment to try to dump the pass off and sidestep the sack, but Sargent wrapped him up and wouldn't let him go.
And Sargent took an inside charge that time, Craig, and Matt Cox was out there. He was hinging, trying to force the man inside. Sarkisian pulled up. You see where Sargent was on the inside? Cox wanted Sarkisian to run around and continue on the rollout. Take a look again. Watch Sargent's charge. He's inside here. You can't see him, just off the left of your screen. Sarkisian needs to continue out and allow Cox to make that block for him and then challenge the corner.
Second sack of the day on Sarkisian. Cougar defense with 2 sacks on Arianas. Sarkisian guns and fires complete. K.O. Kalalui at the 47 of Fresno State. Steve Wilson, right side cornerback on coverage, number 7 out of Moreno Valley, California.
Good protection this time for Sarkisian as he drops back to throw. He's got time to read the field and then throw in that lane in between the linebackers. Kalalui makes a nice catch to come back and get that football. The ball a little bit behind him, and he makes a good catch of it.
Blaine, really maybe the strongest throw in the sense of velocity on the day for Sarkisian. Inside Bulldog territory, 47-yard line, first and 10. Back to the ground. Atuaya, maybe 2 yards to the 45. He was ridden down by 69, Chris Showalter, and the right end, number 57, Steve Kasner. 2-yard gain for Mark Atuaya. Clock running. 12:45 to play, third quarter. Opening drive here in the second half, and ooh, the Bulldogs send the blitz, and now flags fly.
And you may get not only an offsides penalty, but you may get an unnecessary roughness penalty. When you come and you're offsides, if you hit the quarterback, they have the right, the officials, to throw a penalty for an unsportsmanlike conduct and unnecessary roughness. I'd be interested to see if that happens, and that is the case.
And Love gets a round of applause as he comes off the field. And he came out of there just shooting cannons, yeah.
So you see, he had the hands on the head of the quarterback, and then and Hayne Mooley comes in and says, hey, you don't hit my quarterback. He put his hands on Sarkisian's head and pushed him down, and then Hey, Mooley went in and was had a few words to say for Love. And that's the right call. They're going to make it every time. When you come unabated to the quarterback and you're offside, you can't lay a hit on the quarterback. And he put his hands to the head of quarterback Steve Sarkisian.
Went right over the top of Morris Unatoa. Brings up first and 10 from the 30-yard line of Fresno State. Great play fake by Sarkisian. He's got KO. Touchdown, Brigham Young. So after the penalty, Brigham Young cashes in on the big touchdown from Sarkisian to Kealalui. His second reception for 6 on the season.
Kealalui was just running the post route right in the seam of that zone, and Sarkisian throws an absolutely perfect strike to Kealalui in the back of the end zone on that post route. And now Hansen will have a chance to put his second earned extra point of the football game on the board for BYU.
Now the kick is up and through. So BYU takes the opening kick here in the third quarter and marches down for a touchdown. 17-14. Brigham Young will come back. Kealalui with the KO punch. Six plays, 70 yards, 2:35 off the clock, and here's KO Kealalui having his left hand taped up after that 30-yard touchdown catch from Sarkisian to put Brigham Young on top, 17-14. Arnold back to receive the kick from Hansen, and Arnold at the one. And Arnold at the 20-yard line. Let's go downstairs. Doug Miller, Doug.
A good point there, the protection that Sarkisian got on that drive. In the four plays prior to the touchdown, he got 4 seconds in the completed pass, then they ran a play, then the penalty, and then on that strike for the touchdown, he had a full 3.5 seconds of protection to get that pass off. Offensive line definitely doing a better job of giving him some time in the pocket right now.
Well, you mentioned that the halftime talk was emotional, and then Brigham Young responds with a very impressive drive, thanks to that penalty also for roughing up Sarkisian, and they take a 3-point lead. At the conclusion of today's game, we'll select the Geneva Steelman Player of the Game, brought to you by Geneva Steel, becoming America's cleanest steel maker. Jerome Oliver, the ball carrier, maybe a yard, wrapped up by Bloomfield. And guess who's back? Shea Muirbrook.
Yeah, this is taking nothing away from Spencer Reed, who filled in for Shea Muirbrook in the first half, but you're going to have a big drop-off when one of the premier linebackers in the Western Athletic Conference sits out a half of football, and Fresno State found the running in the middle a little easier without Shea Muirbrook there.
Second down and 8. The completion to Charlie Jones, and he is so dangerous after the catch. Timmy McTyre, left cornerback, had to chase him down, got some help from Brad Martin, but you got like Charlie Jones, he makes that little quick hitch after the catch, and he'll spring you for 5 or 6 more.
Well, and Tim McTyre is a defensive back that really likes to lay it, let it all hang out, and give you a great hit. And you can't do that with Charlie Jones. You have to break down and let him come to you. If you try to unload on him, he'll make you miss every time and miss big.
A pickup of 7 brings down up a 3rd down and 3. They give it inside and a 1st down. Oliver, little misdirection. Jamie Cook put the helmet on Jerome Oliver, 200-pound senior. Jamie, big week against Utah a week ago, had 10 tackles against the Utes.
Well, just an inside trap. And Arianas audible to that saw. The linebacker shifted over and audible to that trap play. It was very effective for a 1st down.
Play action, Arianas with a quick zip and the, what are you going to call? Complete. One official looking at the other, and they're going to mark it at the 45-yard line. Warren Fortier, the tight end, pulling down his 10th catch of the season. He's a hometown boy out of Fresno.
He's a big tight end at 240 pounds, 6'2", just roaming the underneath coverage. And Fresno goes with the play action pass. Fortier goes down and gets the ball underneath the coverage of Eddie Sampson.
Pickup of 9, second down and short. And Reggie Brown rumbles up the middle. Shea Muirbrook made the stop, but a pickup of 5 and another first down for Fresno State. Good at doing a good job, but they've done a good job in this football game, mixing pass and run.
When your quarterback is on target, as Arianas is today, that's a nice luxury. He has been right on with his throws today.
Jim Sweeney against Lavelle Edwards. Play fake again. Arianas good downfield coverage. He's going to have to dump it off, and he does. And how about that open field tackle by McTyre on Oliver? Oliver came back to help out as the safety valve, but McTyre stayed home and did a nice shoestring tackle on Oliver.
Boy, and Arianas bought some extra time. Wanted to go with the football upfield and used his feet to buy some extra time. The coverage downfield was excellent for BYU. And if you're going to have a man in the open field, a secondary man in this league, I can't think of anybody you'd rather have out there than Tim McTyre to make a one-on-one tackle.
A loss of 1, second down 11. 2 receptions, 10 yards on the day for Oliver. Arianas rolls and guns, and it's a one hopper incomplete. The intended receiver was Jaheen Arnold.
Boy, Tim McTyre came up limping. Looks like he got his legs tangled up with Arnold on the play and trying to jog that off right now. I noticed the play before that Dermell Reed came out, took himself out of the football game, and sent James Dye in at that other corner.
Fresno State in the first half was quick to pick on Dye after Dermell Reed went down with that knee injury again in the first half. They're going to line up Roberson to the far side, so you got Roberson and Dye one-on-one. Arianas rolls and guns and breaking into the flat. Incomplete. Charlie Jones. Boy, what acceleration. He stopped, looked, and then had to try to play catch up.
But Charlie Jones was on a curl and go route. He came on the curl, and Arianas bought himself a little extra time. Boy, did he get hit as he let go of the football. He stood right in the pocket and took the big hit from 2 BYU defenders. And Jones just could not get to the football. Arianas had to throw it just a half a second before he wanted to and couldn't get the accuracy on the football.
Dye from the 14. And not much there. Dye tackled and dropped at the 16, maybe the 17-yard line. Alfonso Bigelow wrapped him up. We'll step aside. BYU will have the football when we come back. Cougars by 3. Back at Bulldog Stadium, Fresno, California. Brigham Young with the football, leading 17-14. Sarkisian, 13 of 15. 175 yards, pair of touchdowns. Hey, Mooley. Hey, Mooley bangs to the 26, maybe the 27-yard line. What the conclusion of today's game? Watch for the Macy's play of the game, brought to you by Macy's Food and Drug, where you save more on your overall grocery bill.
With both of these quarterbacks, Greg, having very accurate throwing days. Sarkisian's been right on the money today as well.
Well, hey, Mooley really, Blaine, has not played a factor in this football game. In the first half, only 2 yards rushing, and he caught one ball for 17 yards. We saw him kind of wince a little bit in the first half. Another quick hitter up the middle, and no go. It was second down and short, and Hamuli loses a yard. Shantonia Sargent breaks through to make the hit, number 91 in the Long Beach, California.
But BYU just tried to get a quick inside trap opened up, and it looked like Sarkisian didn't get the snap crisply from center Morris Unatoa, and it kind of messed up the timing of that play, and Fresno State played it very well on the defensive front.
Ryan Holmes also there to plug the hole. Third down and 1. Crowd comes alive in Fresno. And Mooley lines up near side as a slot back. And on the bootleg, Sarkisian with a dump. Hey, Mooley. Circus catch, 35 to the 38-yard line. First down, Brigham Young. Marlon Jackson, the strong safety, and a little Houdini act that time by Sarkisian.
Well, Hemuli was blocking up on the outside, and just at the last second, he releases his block, and he becomes the pass receiver. See him working there against Sargent, and Hemuli sure made a nice adjustment back to the football. Sarkisian did what he had to. He got it over the top of Sargent with a little jump pass. Nice touch on the ball, allowed Hemuli to make that adjustment and pick up the first down for BYU.
Hemuli now 27 consecutive games. He's caught a pass. Mike Johnston in motion, first and 10 from the 38-yard line. Sarkisian guns and fires to Cooper to the 40 to the 38-yard line of Fresno State. Jackson and Wilson drop Cooper. Jason Cooper, not really the go-to guy in this offense, but when he gets the football, he makes some things go.
This time they used the play action, held the linebackers, and then they ran Mike Johnston deep and brought Jason Cooper right under. You see Johnson going deep there on the right hand of your screen? He ran the secondary off, and then Cooper cut underneath, and Sarkisian threw the ball with a nice velocity on it for the completion to Cooper.
20th catch of the season for Cooper. First down, Brigham Young at the Fresno State 38-yard line. Sarkisian wants to go the other way, and he does. Oh, the hit. Down goes Johnson. Dustin Johnson, Chris Love, not fooled on that play.
When Chris Love played the man that time and made the hit, which was the sure tackle, you know, the conservative thing to do. But it looked like he had enough time to actually come up, step in front of that ball and intercept it. You take a look. Here he is, and he played the man, just kind of misplayed the ball a little bit. He should have been able to get a hand on that. And the big hit laid on by Love on the reception.
That's 3 yards the hard way. I'll tell you what, Dustin Johnson, big fella, 230. Love checks in at 210. Atuaya, the lone back. Sarkisian with the bootleg, and now the flip to Haymooly. And Emma tripped up at the 27. Jackson made the shoestring tackle, but Sarkisian, again, able to kind of sidestep that heavy bulldog rush and got the ball out to Haymooly.
That's just great presence. Now Sarkisian comes on the bootleg. If they're blitzing, that means that nobody's there to cover Hemuli. He knows that. When they bring the outside linebacker in the end, nobody's going to be out there. All you have to do is flick the ball out. And he had the presence of mind to get it out there to Hemuli and pick up the yardage.
First down, Brigham Young at the Fresno State 28. Boy, very impressive numbers. 17 of 19, only two misfires. 231 yards and a two touchdown. Cougars looking for more, leading by three. Again, the play fake. Good protection over the middle. K.O. Kalului at the 10. High steps it up to the 6-yard line, maybe the 7. Ryan Holmes hit him in the numbers.
Point Kalului got up and shaking his head like he took a good hit. Sarkisian continues to impress with his reads and accuracy this afternoon. They went with a play-action pass, faked the draw trap, and then got Kalului on top of the linebackers for the completion.
First down, goal at the 7. Impressive march down the field by Brigham Young. 6:10 to play, third quarter. Tafua chopped down at the 6. Bloomfield, maybe a yard. Stoutmeyer made the tackle, and Stoutmeyer slow to get up. He went down low and chopped the legs out of Tafua Bloomfield.
Boy, he's shaking up a little bit. This is why Stoutmeyer leads the whack in tackles. He just flies up from his free safety position and makes the tackle. He is a very, very active run support type of free safety.
Two times the Cougars have penetrated the red zone, one touchdown, one field goal. Second down, goal from the 5. Into the end zone, touchdown. Kaipo Maguire had a touchdown last week against Utah and stacks on another.
When Fresno State decided they were going to take a gamble, they put eight people in the box on the line of scrimmage. You see all the linebackers coming. That means man-to-man coverage with no help in the middle, and it is very difficult to ask your secondary to cover man-to-man on that slant route, and that time Steve Wilson was easily beat by Kaipo McGuire on the slant.
Third touchdown throw of the day for Sarkisian.
And Hansen puts through another Ernst extra point to put BYU up 23-14 in this football game. Or 24-14, Craig.
One more time, Sarkisian with good protection and the quick toss. And Kaipo McGuire scores six. We'll be back. Well, the lights are on. Bulldog Stadium. Look at the scoring drive. Nine plays, 82 yards. 4:23 off the clock for Brigham Young and Kaipo McGuire. Five-yard catch from Sarkisian. And boy, Sarkisian, very, very impressive. We questioned what type of game he would have after coming off the four interceptions against Utah, and he has been about as sharp as we've seen all season.
That's right. He's completed 10 straight passes, and we haven't seen many footballs on the ground in this football game for either team in the passing game.
24-10, Brigham Young trying to hold on to Holiday Bowl hopes. Hansen with the kick. Arnold at the 6, Arnold at the 20, and he hits a wall at the 22-yard line. And that wall was Dustin Johnson. Let's go downstairs, check in with Doug.
A little bit of irony as to what fired the Cougars up on that offensive series. Number 17, the linebacker Love, that blitzed in and offsides took Sarkisian to the ground. Well, several of Sarkisian's friends have said he plays best when he's mad, and that really burned him up. And right in Love's face, he said, "Is that all you got?" And it brought such a crowd and such a cheer and laughter from some of the Cougars. They think that may be the pivotal moment so far in this game right now in terms of getting the Cougars fired up.
Now Sarkisian plays better when he's mad, huh? So far, so true. Arianis to the air and connects with Roberson. And a first down for Fresno State at the 41. Eddie Sampson going one-on-one with Roberson.
It'll be interesting to see where the flag comes, because Jermell Reed immediately turned around and complained to the officials about something. And the pass right on the money by Arianis again. And Jermell Reed out there on that bad knee. And the penalty is going to be a personal foul against BYU. I think they may have gotten a hold of that face mask.
Let's listen in.
After the play was over, personal foul, 15-yard face mask against the defense, tacked on to the end of the run.
Well, that's intentional, the 15. And that will not make that man happy at all.
And this is a pivotal drive in the football game. This is where Fresno State stays in the game or BYU puts Fresno State away. And you can bet that that helps this drive with Fresno State's momentum. They've at least got to come away with this drive with 3 points.
Arianis, impressive, 18 of 25, 213 yards. Play action, going for the home run ball. He's got his man, Roberson! Brian Roberson. Oh, he's got the breakaway speed. And we talked about, can the Bulldogs answer back? They answered, and they are barking loud.
You got Jermell Reed out on an island at the quarterback position on the outside. He's got no help in the middle of the field at all. And Roberson, just with outstanding speed, outruns Jermell Reed all the way to the end zone. Of course, Jermell Reed working on that bad knee, that left knee.
He's got about a wheel and a half, but still the breakaway speed by Roberson, and the extra point is good. And hey, buckle up, good football game. 4:46 to play in the third quarter, and Jim Sweeney's Bulldogs have cut the lead to 3.
Let's take a look again as BYU elects to leave the center of the field uncovered. They're going man to man, and Fresno State ran a crossing route underneath and brought the free safety up. Jermell Reed not able to keep up with Roberson.
5 catches, 103 yards. How about the average, huh? 20, almost 21 yards, a catch, two touchdowns on the day. Roberson started this day with the touchdown in the first quarter. He had three touchdown receptions at the start of this game through the first 11 games of the season. He's almost doubled that with two today. Two plays, 75 yards. How about that, 34 seconds off the clock. Bulldogs struck and struck in a hurry.
When they needed to do that, they needed to get points in that drive because you could feel that momentum going BYU's way. And now it's right back on the red side of the field with the Fresno State Bulldogs.
James Dye awaits. He scares me just looking at it.
You know, he really hasn't had a chance to get a full run on any of his returns today. Fresno State's done a nice job of getting hang time under their punts and kicking the ball high on the kickoffs. They've had good cover in this football game.
Well, he's built for speed, isn't he? Taken at the 17-yard line, and Tafua Bloomfield to the 27, maybe the 28. So a 10-yard return, and Brigham Young, good field position at the 27-yard line. DeMarco Ford made the tackle.
Boy, in a football game like this where these offenses have come alive here in the second half, every drive is a pivotal drive. If you don't score on a drive, that could be cost you the football game. You need to be able to move the ball down the score on every series, it seems like.
Mike Johnson in motion. Here comes Hayden Ruley on the draw. Chase from behind. Good, good. Defensive effort by Kevin Adams, the freshman out of Stockton, California. The BYU's got their freshman linebacker in Brad Martin, and Fresno State's got their own freshman in Kevin Adams. Good-looking kid at 6'3", 220.
BYU just going to run the draw trap and watch Adams come from the backside. He read that all the way and ran Hamuli down from behind.
No gain on the play. Brings up second down and 10. And the Bulldogs show blitz, and Sarkisian steps back and calls time. We'll keep it here. Omar Stoutmeyer was up on the line, and he was digging the cleats in.
At BYU, I'm sure Sarkisian wanted to get into a blitz all that time. Fresno State came up on the line of scrimmage, but there were only 8 seconds left on the play clock. Not enough time for Sarkisian to get out of the play. Craig, that Mississippi State basketball team is supposed to be just absolutely loaded this year with talent.
Yeah, went to the Sweet 16, don't forget.
It was a young team last year.
Early season test for Roger Reed. Not a lot of pressure down there in Provo. They've been picked to finish in the middle of the pack. Say the pressure's on Utah, number 8 in the country. And before today's matchup with number 2 Kansas, Sarkisian having a day. 19 of 21, 246 yards and the 3 touchdowns. Here comes the rush. Sarkisian running for his life. And he gets sandwiched at the 23. Andre Griggs, Kevin Adams, Leroy Colbert really bringing the pressure.
But I'll tell you, Sarkisian did a job just to get back to where he did to avoid a big loss. Fresno State defense came clean. And you see him scramble around. He picked up some blockers, but the coverage downfield was also excellent. That was Andrew Jones who applied the early pressure. Beat Larry Moore to the inside, and then Sarkisian is just trying to find a place to hide, and no receivers open downfield. And he did a good job just to avoid a 15-yard loss. And it'll bring up a 3rd and 14 situation now for BYU.
Now crowd coming alive. 3rd down conversions for Brigham Young, 4 of 7 on the day. This crowd, though not a sellout, very noisy at Bulldog Stadium. 3rd and 14, Sarkisian buying time on the rollout. He's got a man, Keanu Louie, at the 41. 1st down, BYU.
When Sarkisian delivered a nice throw, and he was just nailed as he let go of the football again by Andrew Jones. rolling out to the right. Going to throw this ball, set his feet and let it fly, and then you can see he takes a hit from the backside by Jones, and look at Kialuhi go out and get that football. We know that Kialuhi's got a bad hand, that left hand heavily taped. He still comes up with a big catch for BYU.
It's like the left thumb. I've noticed Sarkisian has worn a brace on his plant foot most of the season. He's out there today braceless. A little bit more mobility on the rollout. They've been running a lot of bootlegs. Straight back is Sarkisian over the middle. Flags are down. Johnston with the catch, still on his feet. And down to the 45-yard line, but a flag on the far side of the field.
He may get Johnston for starting forward with his motion before the snap of the football.
Stripes today, huh?
Yeah, that's going to be the call. Pretty close call there.
Illegal motion on the offense. 5 yards, repeat first down.
I just saw when he threw the flag and figured that's what it was. That was, I don't know. That was pretty iffy. I don't know if I'd have thrown a flag on that one. That was pretty close.
2.5 minutes to play, third quarter, 24-21, Brigham Young. First and 15. To Haymooley, near side. Haymooley to the 43-yard line. A pickup of two. Stoppmeyer again. Hanging around the football, picks up another tackle.
Sarkisian has completed his 12th straight throw in this game. They cleared out the upfield coverage with the Tula Mealy. It's nice to have a tight end that can get up the field and deep to clear out the coverage, and then brought Haymooley underneath.
So a pickup of three, second down seven, 21 of 23, 267 yards now, with 1:35 to play in the third quarter. Bulldogs send the blitz. Sarkisian stacked up, running for daylight, and he hooks up with Johnston. He takes a hard shot out of bounds at the 43-yard line of Fresno State, and the man who delivered that hit, Omar Stoppmeyer.
But I'll tell you, the protection that time for Sarkisian was outstanding. You see that linebacker blitz. Fresno State's coming after him with eight people that time, playing man-to-man coverage in the secondary. The line did an excellent job. Allows Sarkisian to step up in the pocket and make the throw on the run to Mike Johnston for the first down yardage.
Stoutmeyer last week, 19 tackles. I mean, 9 tackles is a game, but 19. Under a minute and a half to play in the quarter. Kialuhi in motion. Haymooley up the middle, still on his feet, bangs to the 30, to the 29-yard line. First down, Brigham Young, Woody Green, Marlon Jackson.
Well, Fresno State has been getting very aggressive on the last couple of drives, coming up close to the line of scrimmage, bringing linebackers. And when they do that, if you can pop a quick opener through the first line of defense, your running back is into the secondary. Stoutmeyer was the first man to make the hit, the free safety. Take a look at that trap inside. Larry Moore's going to pull to the right side, make the trap. Look at that quick opener. And then the seal block by Fapulo, the right guard, makes for a nice hole. Stoutmeyer right there as he comes through the line of scrimmage, but Haymooley breaks that tackle and gets into the secondary.
Yeah, one of the few tackles Stoutmeyer has been unable to hang on. Mike Johnston coming the other way. Inside the 20 to the 16-yard line, Andre Griggs made the tackle. Well, misdirection. Fresno State flowing one way. They bring Johnston coming at you the other. And nice throw by Sarkisian, and the streak continues.
Flanker screen this time. They line him up wide out to the left. And you see Haymooley and McGuire blocking. Now look at Uwantoa get down the field. Throw that quick flanker screen. It's an easy throw. And if your flanker gets a seam, it's just a big yardage.
First and 10. Fresno State 16-yard line. Impressive drive, play action, Sarkisian protection to the end zone, and overthrows Haymooley, incomplete, threw that ball away. Good downfield coverage by the Bulldogs.
Sarkisian showing a lot of patience today. That was a good throw. He had Atulamili in the end zone, covered. He had Haimuli covered up the sideline and didn't take the sack, avoided any bad things happening, and threw the ball out of the end zone.
Well, Sarkisian uses a lot of receivers. Six receivers with 20 or more catches on the season. Second down, 10. The pump, Sarkisian has to tuck it back down, hits Haimuli, and as he made his cut, he goes down at the 9-yard line.
Boy, and Haimuli upset with himself. He had Jason Cooper out in front to block for him. Only one defender on the play over there, and that was Andre Griggs, the linebacker. And Haimuli just could not plant the foot and get it upfield.
I don't know if Doug Miller can hear me, but Doug, you mentioned earlier in this game, this grass is short, very, very tightly cut.
It's almost like a golf green type grass. It's cut very close. It's not wet. The soil or the subsoil is not wet where it tears loose, but it's just almost as though you scrape the entire turf and roots loose. And several cuts, both for the Bulldogs and for the Cougars today. Footing's been a problem.
I'd like to have that in my front yard, huh? All right, we played three quarters. 15 minutes to go at Bulldog Stadium. Brigham Young 24 and Fresno State 21. We'll be back. Stay tuned. Bulldog Stadium, Fresno, California, and the Brigham Young Cougars knocking on the door at the 13-yard line. Checked at the 7-yard line. Current drive. Cougars have really chewed up some clock. Hand off. Haimuli. Touchdown.
Point again, Fresno State puts a lot of people on the line of scrimmage. They're playing a gambling defense here in the second half on a lot of occasions. And if you pop Haimuli through that first line of defense with your linebackers coming, there's nothing but secondary behind you. And Haimuli's able to get it into the end zone. Only needed 3 yards for the first down, but got the touchdown. And now Hansen will have a chance to add another Ernst extra point to his total here in the football game.
Haimuli with his fifth touchdown rushing. And boy, he popped through there nearly untouched. Tough snap, handled and kicked through by Hansen. And the lead now back to 10 for Brigham Young. So the Cougars move 73 yards. Haimuli punches it in, and the Cougar lead is 10. 14:57 to play in the football game. We'll be back. There's Emma Haimuli resting up after running in for six. Seven carries, 34 yards, four receptions on the day for 42. Nine plays, Cougars go 72 yards and 4:46, and Haimuli with a 9-yard run. Hansen with the kick to Arnold at the 4. Arnold at the 20, 25, 30 to the 31-yard line goes Jaheen Arnold out of Sunnyvale, California. Dustin Staley made the tackle. There's the two coaches. On the left is Lavelle Edwards, the fourth winningest active coach. And on your right is Jim Sweeney, the seventh winningest active coach.
We've got a player down for BYU on the cover team. Boy, Arnold today, it just seems like he's one man away from breaking a kickoff for a touchdown. Looks like Phil Giordano with the injury up under his own power. Watch the open field tackle. It's going to be made by Dustin Staley. Again, one man away. Arnold using his great speed, and Staley just comes in and takes the legs out from under. Arnold on the return. Giordano walking under his own power, but with a noticeable limp as he goes to the sideline.
Oliver and Brown in the backfield, and boy, Shea Muirbrook just filled the hole. Muirbrook from that middle backer spot did not play the first half because of the suspension last week. had to sit out the first half of this game, and he's come back fresh.
He got kicked out of a game for a little altercation right at the end of the game, and the rules provide that since he couldn't be kicked out of, there was really nothing to kick him out of last week. It was at the end of the game, so the suspension carries over to the first half of this football game. And I imagine he has a lot more energy than anybody else on the field. He hasn't played.
Oh, yeah. Loss of two, second down, 12. The dump and the catch complete at the 37-yard line. Arnold made the ankle-high catch. Jamie Cook brought him down.
And I don't know how Arianna's got that ball off, because he had defensive linemen draped all over him as he made that throw upfield.
Third down, five.
I said Muirbrook was suspended because he pushed a referee.
Wow. Can't touch those guys.
Cougars showing blitz. And the pass. And they're going to say complete at the 49-yard line. Cougar bench said no. But Brian Roberson making a nice grab. We'll see it again. And Cougars complaining that it was a one-hop scoop catch by Roberson.
Well, if the official makes the call on the BYU sideline, he's got to be pretty sure that Roberson made that catch. Let's take a look from this angle. We're not going to be able to see because his body's in front of the throw, but
first and 10. And now Arianna's down at the 20, back at the 30-yard line.
The last couple of plays, that BYU defensive front has roughed him up a little bit. He was tackled as he threw the play before, and on this play he was hit hard as he let go of the football. Look at the numbers, 21 of 28 for 278 yards. We're seeing a very good passing exhibition by both of these quarterbacks in this football game.
And nearly 600 yards passing between the two. There's Jim Sweeney, who's come out to check on his quarterback. Richie Donati and Arianas have shared duties off and on all season long. There's Richie Donati, a 200-pound junior out of Santa Barbara. He's thrown for nearly 2,000 yards this season, 12 touchdowns, 11 interceptions. And so coming out is Jim Arianas, and checking in will be Richie Donati.
When Donati is no stranger to Brigham Young University. He had a good game last year against the Cougars as a starting quarterback.
1,800, nearly 1,900 yards through the air.
In fact, Donati has 4,162 career yards. He's sixth
all-time
on the all-time career passing list for the Bulldogs, so he's no stranger to being in there. It's not like having a backup quarterback with rust on him coming into the game. Donati should be able to maintain.
Donati comes in, down 10. And the handoff to the big fella, Reggie Brown, banging for yardage, maybe two, maybe three. Matt Redden rode him down.
But Arianas is standing on the side. See him right there, ready to come back into the football game. Had to go out for one play.
So Donati comes right back out, and here comes Arianas. Also, Jamie Kimbrough, the fullback, checks in. So Donati can call home tonight and say, yeah, I played. On the reverse, Arnold wants to throw. Guns it down and incomplete.
You remember last year in the Fresno State BYU game, maybe you won't, but I will, that they opened the game up with a double reverse pass and struck early against BYU. And they take a play out of last year's playbook, but BYU read it very well, had the play covered downfield, and also had the reverse covered well.
Now, Sweeney's the type of coach that he'll pull the trick or two on you.
It was Charlie Jones on the receiving end of that pass last year from David Dunn.
7 of 10 on third down conversions, 3rd and 9. And a nice, oh, nice sideline reception. Roberson has made some nifty grabs today. And again, they're picking on Dye. James Dye filling in for Dermell Reed. And when they needed the big down, the big pass, they've gone to Dye's side.
Well, when you throw that comeback route to the sideline with that accuracy and with that velocity, it's almost impossible to cover no matter who you are. You take your receiver 18 yards up the field like he's going on a streak and then just have him break down. The ball is there as he makes his break. You can't cover it, and Arianas has thrown it well all day.
Six catches, 115 yards, and nearly 20 yards a catch. Pair of touchdowns for Roberson. Bulldogs going to run, and they give the handoff to Jerome Oliver, and they knock a guy in stripes down at the 30. That's one of the hazards of the game. Jerome Oliver, 200-pound senior out of Wichita, Kansas.
That was the umpire, Dean Reimer, who was in on the tackle. Or does got tackled.
Does he get an assist?
I don't know if they give him a tackle, if he shows up in the official stats or what on that.
Jamie Cook also there to help out.
This is the draw trap, Fresno State style, out of the eye. And a big hole opened that time for Jerome Oliver.
Under 12 minutes left to play. Oliver cuts it outside, picks up a couple to the 25. Stop made by Brad Martin, the linebacker. And Redden. And just enough for the first down. So Fresno State, they keep answering back. BYU hits them with a punch. They get up, coming back.
Well, we mentioned earlier in the half that these offenses looked like they had shifted into another gear here in the second half, and you have to keep scoring to maintain suit here.
From the eye, the play fake and the catch. Oliver at the 5-yard line. Oh, he spins down for extra yardage. He actually made the catch at the 10, and Arnold, Jaheen Arnold. And the Bulldogs are right on the front porch, and James Dye had to make the stop.
Arnold started out on the right and ran a crossing route. Stan Ross trying to read the quarterback. And Arianas did a nice job of looking off the receiver. Notice he looked out to his left, didn't give Stan Ross a read. And boy, that was very close to being a late hit by James Dye. Watch how late he comes in. The player's down, and he makes the hit. Did not draw flag, however.
First and goal from the 4. And down to the 2-yard line goes Oliver. Tackled by Redden. And now Dye mixing things up with Charlie Jones.
Two of the little guys out there on the field scrapping with one another.
Those little guys can throw a punch. I'll tell you. Looking right at you, coming right at you is Oliver. And he bangs to the 2. So second down goal from the 2-yard line. A lot of time left in this game. Coming up on the 10-minute, Pittman turns it out, walks in.
Boy, and give Reggie Brown an assist on the play, Craig. He made a great block on the outside for Pittman. Watch number 4, left side of your screen. Watch this cut block. Boom, right there. That's the block that breaks containment for Pittman, and he can just waltz into the end zone for 6.
Pittman with his 7th touchdown of the season on the ground, and boy, makes it look easy. Extra point up and good, 31-28. And a lot of time, 10:15 to go, a flag down after the point. After conversion.
After the extra point was successful, there was a dead ball, personal foul against the defense. It will be assessed on the kickoff.
Cool. Now LaVille Edwards getting the explanation on the sideline. I believe that's 3 personal foul calls against Brigham Young today. We'll take a break with 10:15 to go in Fresno. 31-28 Brigham Young. Lassonde has it teed up at the 50-yard line after the penalty. And he's going to put the full leg into it. And no way Brigham Young will bring this out. Cooper hits a knee at the 5-yard line, so BYU will start up with a 3-point lead at their own 20. Got to be impressed with the way Fresno State has answered back time and time again in this game. 11 plays, 69 yards, and the Bulldogs ran 4:42 off the clock, and Pittman walked in from 2 yards out to make it a 3-point game.
Yeah, the impressive thing about that drive, the last drive was just a quick strike. This time, Fresno State methodically moved the ball down the field, making clutch plays, third down conversions, and got it in the end zone.
Last year, 32-30, Brigham Young. This year, it's 31-28 and a load of time. 10:15 to go. And this crowd could play a factor down the stretch. Hey, Mooley trying to kick it outside and no room to rumble. He's dropped at the 19 by Colbert, the left end, number 55. He's a junior out of Houston, Texas.
And that play was designed to go right up the center of the offense for BYU. And Fresno State's defensive front, Neal and Robinson, did a nice job of spreading that out and forcing Haymooley into Leroy Colbert for the tackle.
No gain for Haymooley, second down 10. Clock running with 9:42 to go. Long snap count by Sarkisian on the bootleg. Bulldogs send the blitz, and Haymooley makes the grab at the 22. Stoppmeyer again. Another tackle on his long list today. Let's go downstairs. Doug Miller. Doug.
Scoring plays largely Sarkisian and Haymooley. I asked Haymooley along the bench here, or one of the trainers did, what fired him up, and he said, it's my senior year. I'm not going to be denied. It's Haymooley that is carrying largely the emotions of this offensive team on his shoulders right now.
Emotions high at Bulldog Stadium. Third down and 7. A sea of red on their feet. Sarkisian. And McGuire with the circus catch at the 42.
Boy, and the coverage was there, Craig. The coverage was right on McGuire. Sarkisian read the blitz. Stoutmeyer came up into the line of scrimmage. He signaled out to McGuire to run the up route and just threw it up and let McGuire go up and get the football. And look at the pickup by Tafua Bloomfield inside on the blitzing Stoutmeyer. Woody Green in coverage on the outside, and McGuire just goes up and gets it right over the top of Woody Green.
And the official right on the money.
Let's see if the foot comes down. There's the left foot and then the right. The left one hit first and then the right, so he was in bounds.
First and 10, Brigham Young at their own 42. Atula Mealy in motion. Sarkisian steps and fires to his tight end, and Mealy to the 46 of Fresno State. Lumumba Neal, big number 95, chased down Mealy from behind.
But Craig, in this game is turning into just what we expect from the Fresno State BYU matchups, an offensive scoring barrage. And they bring Mealy back on just a delay route back to the inside and hope that he can do something with it. Does just that, drags tacklers for 6 yards on the first down.
Mealy not used a lot today, but another first down, 45-yard line of Fresno State. The clock is ticked down to under 8 minutes. Tafua Bloomfield and the flats. Flags come out, and Bloomfield hits the deck at the 31-yard line.
Well, they're going to get Atula Mealy for a clip. You saw it coming as Mealy was breaking to the outside to try to make a block for Bloomfield, and he hit the Fresno defender. Couldn't make out who it was in the back. That's going to be an illegal block in the back. It looked like Steve Wilson that he threw the block on. Now this will go from the spot of the foul.
That's from the 32-yard line of Fresno State.
during the run. Illegal block in the back, 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Repeat first down.
And take a look, watch Mealy as he comes across the field on the replay. Right here on the right side of your screen, Bloomfield cuts back inside, and Mealy just lays the forearm into the back of the head of the defensive back for Fresno State. Take a look as Bloomfield takes a vicious hit at the end of that play by Ryan Holmes, the middle linebacker for Fresno State.
Boy, picture perfect tackle by Holmes. You look at the penalty, 7 flags, 78 yards. Fresno State 6 for 68. First down, 7. And near the first down is Artuaya.
I think he got it. All he needed to do was cross the 35-yard line, and they're going to mark it just inside the 35. So Artuaya on some individual leg drive that time picks up the first down for BYU.
Took Griggs and Love with him. 8 carries on for 31 yards for Artuaya. Less than 4 yards a carry. He's pounded out some tough yards today. Clock running. Brigham Young holding on with a 3-point lead. 31-28 coming up on the 7-minute mark of the fourth quarter. Sarkisian letting that play clock run down to 3 on the bootleg and the flip to Atuaya. Wide open far side. Hurdles to the 21 and to the 17, I believe. Call it the 19-yard line. Well, he took off. Caught some air and picks up 3 extra yards. Stottmeyer made the tackle.
They must have marked him out of bounds, but he did go flying. Sarkisian makes a good read again. They blitzed the linebacker. That means Atuaya is uncovered. They're going to mark him out of bounds with that right foot on the 19-yard line as he leaps over the top of the defense.
Well, that was Chad Lewis's mark. Atuaya has been watching his big tight end. 29 of 32.
He has as many touchdowns as he does incompletes. 3 touchdowns, 3 incompletes. Now that's a ratio.
Reverse, KO, Sarkisian throws a block, Kealalui chased and pursued and knocked out of bounds at the 10-yard line.
Boy, Stoutmeyer will hit you when he comes up. There's no doubt about that. The WAC's leading tackler lowered the boom on Kealalui, but not before a big pickup. And watch the block on the replay of Sarkisian, the quarterback. Keep your eye on number 12 in the middle of your screen. He's going to come out. The play's overrun just a little bit by Leroy Colbert, and then Sarkisian gets in his way enough to spring Kealalui before Stoutmeyer lays the boom on K.O. Kealalui.
And now a timeout on the field. Timeout, Brigham Young. So BYU burns a timeout with 6:39 to play. We'll take a break. BYU 31, Fresno State 28. We'll be back. Now there's the brain trust of Brigham Young. Lavelle Edwards hidden by Norm Chow. Chow coming down off the out of the booth this season to call the offensive plays. Second down, 2 from the 10. Sarkisian from the shotgun. He's going to call his own number, tucks and runs. Touchdown, Sarkisian.
Well, Craig, you've seen San Francisco 49ers do this. You send all of your receivers wide, leave no one but the quarterback, and then you run the quarterback drive a la Steve Young. Sarkisian picks his way through the hole. He's got that ball raised up for the touchdown. And that little left-handed lifted leg is the signal to the center to go ahead and snap the ball when he wants to. And Sarkisian gets over for the touchdown, and now Hansen with a chance to add another earned extra point to his total here in the game.
Kick is up and good by Hansen. Sarkisian from 10 yards out scores his second touchdown on the ground this season. Say, Sarkisian, if there were critics, and there were plenty after Utah and Brigham Young battled last week, he's come back with a football game, I'm telling you.
When he said last week himself, he was quoted several times in the paper, that was probably his worst game of the year against Utah. And I think that this is about the best game he's had of the season this afternoon. Look, 29 out of 32 for 371 yards, three touchdowns passing, and one on the ground for Steve Sarkisian.
Now the question, Fresno State, plenty of time, 6:34 to go. They're down 10, and each time in the second half, Brigham Young has pushed one in. They've answered right back. Cougar fans making the trip. Well, you can't forget about how this game will affect the bowl outcome. Utah alone at the top of the WAC at 6-2, and then the second place 4-team tie, San Diego State, Air Force, Colorado State, and Brigham Young. BYU, they hang on to win, would jump to 6-2 to tie Utah.
I'll tell you, Craig, I see some Fresno State fans heading for the exits, but with 6 minutes to go and the way this Fresno football team has moved the ball, I don't understand anybody leaving. There's still plenty of time left in this football game.
I'd stay put. Arnold at the one. Arnold at full speed, 25-30. And down he goes at the 31-yard line. So a 30-yard return by Arnold.
Phil Giordano on the tackle on that one. But Arnold makes no bones about getting up the field. He just turns it into fifth gear and goes on his returns.
Cougars 9 plays, 80 yards, 3:41 off the clock, and Sarkisian takes it in from 10 yards out. Cougars with a 10-point lead, 6:28 to go. Fresno State, 3 timeouts remaining. They set up the screen and incomplete. Reggie Brown off his shoot tops couldn't hang on. That stops the clock with 6:24 to go.
What a rare misfire for Arianas here in the football game. Reggie Brown was open and he had the screen set up. It just could not get the football. Looked like he wanted to throw it early and Brown wasn't looking. And then when he gathered himself back up again to deliver the football, he couldn't make the throw.
Offensive line has protected Arianas today. Arianas, good timing, protection, and he makes the hit, connects. Charlie Jones dancing. Tried to run east-west instead of north-south. Came back across the field, and he's close to the first down, tackled by James Dye.
When Charlie Jones continues to add to that reception total, and such a fixture in that offense for the last 4 years for the Fresno State Bulldogs, running a curl route back to his quarterback and then cutting across the middle of the field. Take a look, he runs the receiver off and then breaks back to the inside on a curl route. Notice how he comes back to that football, Craig. You keep coming back to your quarterback until the ball is thrown.
They stretch the chains and a first down for Fresno State at the 41 and a half. Charlie Jones, Fresno State's career leader in receptions, yards, and he's tied with Henry Ellard for touchdown receptions.
5 receptions for 47 yards in this football game. Came in with 182, already the reception leader, and just continues to add to that total.
Reggie Brown stops the clock. So the Bulldogs thinking clock management, Timmy McTyre on the tackle. Boy, Reggie Brown, who had his knee scoped on Monday, looks pretty good.
Yeah, that's amazing. That knee looks sound. I mean, for a running back to have a bum knee is very difficult. So he must be pretty stable out there on that knee, and the injury must not have been that bad, or you would be able to make the cuts and take the pounding that he's taking in this football game.
Well, and you have to ask, you look at BYU's defensive strategy right now with just under 6 minutes to go. You play soft, you play your game plan, you know, you just can't drop back. and what give the 5 and 6 yards a play pop right now.
Especially since Fresno State's
intercepted. Intercepted by Cook.
Just as I was going to say, Fresno State's receivers are catching the ball very well underneath. Jamie Cook comes across in front of Arnold and takes the football away. What a huge play for Jamie Cook in the BYU secondary.
Jamie Cook with his first interception. This ball hung just a bit, but right on the money. But Cook slides underneath Arnold for the pick.
And then to add insult to injury, watch the hit that James Dye puts on Arnold after the interception is made. Not only does he give up an interception, but takes a big pop in the process.
So there's Cook celebrating his first interception of the season, and it shuts down a Fresno State drive with 5:46 to play. 38-28 Brigham Young, and now the crowd really filing out of Bulldog Stadium. Bloomfield off the right side picks up three.
BYU needs to get some first downs here. They can't go 1-2-3 punt, and that's a good first down play. You can pick up five on a running play on first down, and that clock continues to roll.
I understand Sarkisian's numbers today, 29-32. New NCAA record for more than 30 throws. He's hit 90.6% of his passes today. The old record was 87.2 by Dick Norman, Stanford University, 1959. It's amazing what our stat guys come up with. Way to go.
Good job.
Cougar staying on the ground of the 40. First down, BYU. Stoutmeyer and Bigelow making a stop on Bloomfield. Well, I'd like to get some numbers on Stoutmeyer.
Yeah, he's just been amazing this year, all year. We mentioned it earlier, 178 tackles coming into this game. You would think you'd get tired making that many tackles all year long.
He's durable, 5'11", 195.
He had two games this year. He had a game against Utah where he made 24 tackles and then a 23 tackle out against UCLA. That's almost unheard of.
Coming off 19, you know, he's had 10 straight double-figure tackle games. We've got him with 11 today. Hey, Mooley, big hole. Breaks it, 50, 45 to the 43. And Stoutmeyer makes it 12 tackles on the day.
Well, this is exactly what BYU wants and exactly what Fresno State cannot let happen, and that is for BYU to keep the ball on the ground, risk no turnovers, and be able to continue to get first downs and let that clock roll.
Well, depending on what happens in the rest of the WAC games today, Utah, of course, idle after completing their season last week against BYU. You have to wonder if another bowl out there taking a look at this game would make an invite to Brigham Young, Liberty Bowl, a possibility. Hey, Mooley, dancing off the right side, pulled down after a 1 yard gain by Kasner. The right end, 57 out of Vacaville, California. Let's check in with Doug Miller. Doug?
I was talking to Chad Lewis on the sidelines, Bowler, a moment ago, and I asked him, you know, what's the difference in Sarkisian this week? How come so glamorous, that great percentage in terms of efficiency? How come it's so different compared to last week? And he said, it's not just the guy, not just the quarterback, it's everybody. It's everybody out there is playing a notch higher tonight. Look at the great runs that Emuli is making, the cuts, the timing. He said everybody's cranked it up a notch this second half, and it makes Sarkisian look good.
But he's particularly sharp this afternoon. His throws have been right on the money and had good velocity on him. And the running game's coming around here in the second half. You know, hey, Mooley, his first five carries, 11 yards, Craig. On his last five carries, he has 41 yards. So he's really turned it up. The offensive line is making some holes for Mooley.
You know, Blaine, we've seen this team so much this year talking about Brigham Young. And if there is one question mark, if there's one confusing point about this team, it's been the question of, are they ready to play week after week? You know, we saw them at the Air Force Academy. They lost to the Falcons big to start the season, 38-12. They lost to UCLA. The And they come back with a couple of wins over San Diego State and Colorado State, who were battling for the WAC championship tonight.
And they got fired up for those, and they sure seemed flat last week in the game we covered against Utah. And now here in the second half of this football game, they've been very fired up. 3 yards rushing in the first half, Greg, 86 here in the second half. They've really turned it up, and they've been getting after it.
Well, if the Cougars do find themselves in a bowl game, there's the yardage on the ground, 99 for Fresno State, BYU 89. I think it's just a question of what team decides to show up is how they will perform. You get some of these problems behind you, this team can click when they want to. 3:50 to go, 38-28, Brigham Young. Bloomfield to the 39. A pickup of one, and Cougars are happy to let that clock run. Sargent, the left end, making the stop.
This brings up a very critical third down situation for Fresno State. This is an absolute must stop. Basically, this is the ball game for them. If BYU is able to get a first down here on third and six, then they've pretty much closed Fresno State out. BYU 7 of 10 today in the third down conversion department.
70%. Any coach would take that. Coming up on the 3-minute mark. Third down, 7. 40-yard line of Fresno State. Sarkisian with a 3-step drop and the pitch. Atula Mealy wrestles to the 35-yard line. Marlon Jackson, the strong safety, able to hold him back from the first down. A pickup of 5, but still 2 yards shy of the first down.
The other thing that happened there was Mealy was thrown out of bounds at the end of the play, and that stopped the clock with 2:57 to go. Fought for that extra yardage, want to get to the first down marker, and then the Fresno State defense does a good job of throwing him out of bounds and killing that clock. Sarkisian continues to have lots of time, putting it in the hands of his big guy and hoping he can do something with it.
I tell you, you looked at half of that BYU offense. They pleaded with head coach Lavelle Edwards, let's go for it on 4th and 2, and they're going for it. Double tight end. Sarkisian looking, gunning. First down and more. Johnston cuts it outside, still on his feet, breaks a tackle, and to the 10-yard line goes Mike Johnston. Chris Showalter made the tackle from his right tackle spot, so big downline pursuit by the 6'3", 255-pound senior.
And why did this look so easy? Because Stoutmeyer fell down in the coverage as he went to break back to Mike Johnston. He slid down. He wasn't there. You don't even see him in your picture. He was so deep and had so much cushion. And then Johnston does his fancy footwork. Great effort by Showalter to come back. He's on the pass rush, ran 30 yards upfield, made that tackle.
Yeah, look at that, 18.5 yards a catch, one touchdown, 4 catches for 74 yards for Johnston. They've come at some very opportune times.
Boy, Craig, that puts Sarkisian over the 400-yard mark in this football game. Over 90% completion percentage and over 400 yards in this game. No interceptions.
About 4 yards on that play. 34.
Picks up 4, clock hitting the 2-minute mark. Brigham Young will finish off the regular season, Blaine, 7-4 and 6-2. And the WAC. Jim Sweeney and his Fresno State Bulldogs will suffer their second losing season back-to-back for Sweeney. They'll finish up at 5-7 and 2-6 in conference play. Atuaya inside the 5 to the 2. Well, for each game, Geneva Steele salutes the outstanding athlete by asking our sports team to select the Steele man of the game. And today's Geneva Steele man, any question? It was unanimous. Steve Sarkisian coming off that rough game against Utah last week with the 4 interceptions. 31 of 34, 401 yards. 4 touchdowns.
You know, this is the easiest decision we've had all year. 3 touchdown passes and 1 running. And that was not a tough vote up here in the booth.
No. Under a minute. 7 on the play clock, 45 on the game clock. Third and short. Amuli dives. Touchdown, Brigham Young. Amuli over the top. Second touchdown of the half.
Boy, and BYU drives down the field. They go with one throw on third and long and then run their way down the field against Fresno, effectively killing the clock and put six more points on the board. And now Hansen will have a chance to add another earned extra point and spread this lead out to 45-28 as Hamuli goes up and over the top for the touchdown.
Kick is up and just makes it inside the far upright. So 45-28 with 38 ticks left on the clock. That matches, by the way, BYU's highest offensive output of the season. They scored 45 against Hawaii, 45 against Tulsa, and now 45 today against Fresno State. I don't think we'll have a problem getting out of the stadium.
Now they've been filing out for a little while now here at Bulldog Stadium. You know, you mentioned bowl scouts other than the Holiday Bowl taking a look at BYU, and I think that one of the things that's got to be impressive to them is this offensive output, and that's what they like in bowl games is excitement. And you're right, if the right BYU team shows up, if the aggressive, ready-to-play BYU team shows up, they can be very offensive-minded and provide some excitement for a bowl.
Well, there's a rare smile. We got to put that and frame it. Lavelle Edwards giving a hug to Atuaya, now Kaipo McGuire. Been a stressful week for Lavelle Edwards.
When they wanted to get that WAC championship for that man, Dermel Reed, you saw hugging Lavelle Edwards. Courageous game that he played, coming back in and out with that knee injury.
There's that record we spoke of, the old record of completion percentage, 87.2. Sarkisian nearly 91% on the day. Line drive kick picked up. Arnold at the 15, at the 30. Goes the other way and loses about 7 yards back to the 23. Then Cook made the tackle. 33 seconds to play.
And Roger French, offensive coordinator for BYU, talking to Lavelle Edwards. And a hug from assistant head coach Norm Chow.
I think the wounds of the past week, maybe not completely healed, but they're starting. Incomplete pass, dropped by Reggie Brown. That stops the clock with 29 seconds to play.
Where Arianas put the ball right on Reggie Brown. He was wide open and started to run before he was able to gather the football in. And that'll stop the clock with 29 seconds.
There's been some pressure on Jim Sweeney. Back-to-back losing seasons. Very rare for a Sweeney coach team. Arianas on play action from the backside. Down he goes. Ed Lamb on the backside pressure. Let's check in with Doug Miller. Doug?
You mentioned the pressure bowler on Jim Sweeney across the field there. Several on the side of the program say Sweeney has brought so much here, no way there's going to be a change until he's ready. And most don't expect that to be the case.
Well, the final gun has sounded. Brigham Young moves to 7-4, finishing the 1995 campaign with a 45-28 win over Fresno State. There's Sweeney and Edwards exchanging hugs at midfield. We'll take a break, come back with some final thoughts. BYU 45, Fresno State 28.